Should we bring our guest in? I think we should. I think we should. Here he comes. Oh, my goodness. What's that picture?
I thought, our friend Eric. What is Eric's title? Eric, is it Eric Jones? What does he do back there? The kid who looks like the white supremacist?
Wait, which one are you talking about? Both could qualify.
Eric Jones.
Eric Jones had a good idea. An idea called the Mike Bocchetti GPS system. So I thought Mike, as a classically trained actor, could make some money if he was the voice of a GPS in your car, right, Brent?
Brilliant.
So I sat down and I figured out what that might sound like. And here is my, would you be willing to do this to make some voiceover money if you were the voice of a GPS in your car?
In a heartbeat. I want to become part of that big Hollywood machine, absolutely.
If someone can tell me what Mike just said, once again, they'll receive a brand new 1974 Dodge Aspen.
Absolutely. I want to become...
All right.
Okay. Thank you, buddy.
Here is Mike Bocchetti, GPS for your car. Go ahead, Mike.
Okay. Turn right in 600 feet. Proceed 2.3 miles and turn left. In 300 feet, bear on Decanter Street. Recalculating. In 0.7 miles, veer on Highway to 90 East. At 6 inches, make a K-turn into order to go to the direct opposite of the previous way you were going. Oof, sorry. Thank you. So I love you guys. Recalculating. Drive 6.7 yards to a red light. Stop car, get out of the car, and turn right. Sorry. Actually, you should have been in the car when you...
I love that. That's and here he is, Mike Bocchetti.
Well, this is wild.
Mike Bocchetti. Yeah, there you are. You're right there with the wonderful Cumia pool in the background.
Thank you for having me, buddy.
Much, much better days.
You're such a good person. Thank you.
Oh, well, that's debatable, do appreciate you saying that.
In my brain, you are. Who cares about what I'm saying?
That's good. I love that.
No, but pot, I have a great idea how you can cash in a pot market.
Ooh, haven't thought of this. Do tell.
We should go to like Colorado, one of the places where it's popular now, right? Open our own little store. Listen to this. Outside, there's all chess boards. You know how the heads like to get into the head.
They
right?
do. Those hipster heads love a little chess.
You go inside, there's a penny candy thing with all kinds of exotic candy.
Penny candy?
Right? In the back.
It's like the general store in fucking Little House on the Prairie.
In the back, there's an art gallery with all stuff to make the heads trip.
This is an amazing I could see you going to the bank asking for a loan for this operation.
Right.
And then there's artwork in the back and chess thing. What?
And then they could buy whatever they want in the back. Souvenirs, pot, brown, anything they want. But think about it. You're entertaining all of them. They're playing chess. They're eating. They're getting stoned.
It would be like one of the arcades, the pinball arcades back in the 80s.
Yeah.
Same thing, only now it would be weed and chess and artwork.
Well, open places has like all different kind of foods. Like in Seattle when I went there, right? I had... peanut butter on a hot dog.
That doesn't.
It was
sound
good.
Good. That doesn't sound.
I was
good.
A former fat guy at the time, but I'm kind of
peanut butter on a hot dog.
Yeah.
have you had it since, or is that a delicacy that they only serve in Seattle?
That was the only Seattle food.
That sounds like something a guy on heroin would eat because he's starving and only has peanut butter and heroin.
Anthony, there are other people that learn you don't mess with either, right? These are the golden rules.
Who's that?
Don't mess with waiters.
Waiters,
restaurants or waitresses, because
they'll spit in your food, right?
They'll spray Raid on your hamburger. I'm sure if they're at.
What if you ask for Raid on your? No, I've never heard of spraying Raid on a burger.
Well, you never.
Big fear is spit. Like Raid, you could be like, this burger tastes like fucking Raid. Take it back. But spit, you're not going to taste it. They're going to get the satisfaction. You're just going to leave like nothing happened.
My mom's the worst. Went into a restaurant one day.
She waiter?
She goes. Oh. This table looks filthy. Where are the buttheads? Serve this thing.
Oh.
And I'm, you know, listening to myself, let's get out of here, please. She goes, no, we're staying here. We're going to eat here now.
Oh, boy.
What are you out of your mind?
Sometimes mom don't know best. No, you got to fucking pick her up and say, get out of here. You're fucked up.
Don't F with your dentist or your hairstylist. Don't mess with them, because especially the dentist. You get a root canal you don't need if you're fucking in an argument with them. You know?
You think if you say something that offends your dentist, he's going to throw away all bit of ethics and all those Hippocratic oaths that they have to take to fuck up your dentistry because because you said something? You're an anti-dentite, as they say on
Some
Seinfeld.
People I know, my doctor's a character. He saved my life, actually. He told me back in February, he goes, your body's 45% fat mass.
45%? That's pretty, what's it supposed to be?
Probably like 3%.
3%?
I don't even really know. I'm not really sure, but... He said that to me, he goes...
Not 45, though.
He goes,
we can assure you, it's not 45, whatever it is.
He said to me, he goes, you want to be around, and he gave me a lecture. And the thing is, you know, I said to myself, look, I went home that night and I'm like, I don't want to wind up being found in a pile of Krispy Kreme donuts waiting for Chinese food. You know?
It's worse ways to go.
I love your place here. What I want to have is a castle in the south of France that I built.
That'd be a castle in the south of France that you built brick by brick.
And have spider monkeys heaping dog shit at idiots.
Spider monkeys that throw shit?
Dog shit at people I don't like. Like invite
they,
them,
you know, let me tell you something. Spider monkeys have their own shit. They don't even need dog shit. They're self-shitting.
And them just heaving to fucking idiots. I love it.
So there's this big castle south of France. You're running the whole show. Are you a... are you a nice leader?
Yeah, I'm
or do you rule with an iron fist?
Parts of me are Caligula, Caesar, and Julius thrown in, but occasionally.
Oh, okay, a little Caligula. Well, that's where the hot chicks come in. So you can dip your hand in lard and just punch them in the asshole. That's a good Caligula move. I watched Boardwalk Empire, and apparently Al was very fond of his kid. So, you know, no, maybe he did have a bit of
his
a
son was. His son was deaf, I think, in real life. Sonny.
What?
His son, Sonny, right? That was his
what?
Name. Al Capone's son.
What?
Was that? I just got it now. Sorry about that.
What about, like, are your grandparents or anything still alive?
No, I wish they were. My grandfather died in the 70s. My
he was in his 70s or in the 70s?
In the 70s. He's in his 50s, right? My grandmother died.
In his 50s? Yeah. In the 50s?
Oh, I died in 1970 at 57.
In his 50s in the 70s. let me tell you.
I'm a bobblehead when it comes to women, no. You know what
you're
I mean?
A bobblehead when it comes to real life. Look at you. Look at you. You're great.
I'm like, yes, honey. Yes, right.
So, yeah, are you like pussy whipped?
I probably would
girl?
Be. If I had a,
oh,
you know what I mean?
You
I got
can't
a man
be
up.
That either.
No, they don't like those guys.
And I'm speaking out of experience here, but I was just as bad, if not worse, than any pussy whipped motherfucker you could ever find. I was the sorriest motherfucker when it came to girls. Just afraid they were gonna leave me and why don't you love me as much as I love you? All that bullshit. No. Oh, I could go back in time and just punch myself in the face. That's what I would do. DeLorean, fuck 1955. Fuck the Under the Sea dance, Enchantment Under the Sea dance. I would go back to 13-year-old Anthony. 13 and fucking door would open up. 13-year-old Anthony stand there going, what the fuck is that? It's amazing. Who's this fucking old guy that kind of looks like me with a little less hair and his teeth look good though?
I would go back that young too, but just change ourselves. You know what?
Right.
Because even bullies are picked on me. I would have beat up more people than Al Capone did for idiots to beat, but I'd probably
be punch
now.
I would fucking punch myself in the face and go, you little faggot. What are you doing? You're wasting time. And then you know what he would do? The younger Anthony would just start sucking dick his whole life and get addicted to crack. So all of a sudden, I'd go back to the future, get out, and I'd just be this cock-sucking drug addict. And younger me would be like, I fucking showed you for punching me. It's called a paradox.
One of my favorite people I met was Lou Diamond Phillips.
Now, that's an odd one of the best people I ever met. Why Lou Diamond Phillips? That's the La Bamba guy.
Yeah, I love him, man. He's like, because I even said that to him when I met him.
La Bamba? Yeah, right. Did you sing La Bamba?
I was about to sing Oh Donna to him, but I thought.
All right, that
twice,
was another
right?
big hit.
But no, what happened was he came to a comedy club years ago, the New York Comedy Club. Some people knew him. He came to say, watch us, right? I got super starstruck when I seen him back in like 96.
Oh.
He was like on Broadway doing A King and I, right?
From the Young Guns, right? He was in Young Guns,
oh,
too.
Oh, yeah. Chavarez.
Yeah.
Jen, I know.
Chavez?
Oh, yeah. I know all, like, you know, yeah. like redundant stuff that's, like, good and, you know.
It's always good to know a little bit about a lot of things. It's better to know a little about a lot of things than be, like, one, you know a whole bunch about one thing.
So I said to him, I go, I was like a five-year-old kid waiting at a New Kids on the Block concert when I seen him.
Sure.
You know what I mean, right? And I said to him, I love you, La Bamba. That's the first thing I said to him, right?
In 90, what was
96.
This? And what year did La Bamba come out?
Like 10 years later.
That was earlier.
He looked at me and he goes, thanks, Mike. You know, I introduced myself to him. I'm like, but he was very cool. And
Were the chicks all over him?
No, he had his wife with him, who he was married to at the time.
Was she hot?
She was hot, but she was like really wasted and drunk and yelling stuff.
That's hot. That's hot. Drunk and wasted.
No, but he was a gentleman, though. He goes, I got to get her out of here before we have some problems.
In other words, I can't hang out and talk to you.
No, but he's lucky.
He got blown off. He used his drunk wife as an excuse.
She was hot with those big tit 40 nurse's outfits. Oh,
do you like the nursey outfit? I'm not sure I like those.
No, from the 40s, though, they look so... Women must have been skanks in the 40s. Look at some of
I think movies. They were. Big hairy bushes.
No, but those,
wonderful.
Those Andrew sisters looking girls.
The Andrew sisters. Yeah, they're kind of goofy looking, though.
No, but they had some tittage.
Oh, they did. Well, but they were like pointy and shit. Yeah, look at her. There's a girl. Hey, who's this?
That's when I should have been born, Anthony. I'm telling you, I should have been around when she was here.
Yeah.
You know how probably had to talk to her? Hey, doll, how about some sarsaparilla?
Hey, doll, how about some sarsaparilla? Nice pair of stems on her. Yes. Hey, who's this? Who's this?
Lady Trucker.
Oh, Christ. You got to be like a Jedi with these women. They're
crazy. Be mysterious like the Fonzies.
Be mysterious like the Fonz. Love it. Yes, Mike. Yes.
Some girl told me that one time.
Be mysterious.
She goes, be cool like the Fonz. Don't be predictable. You know.
There you go. The Fonz wasn't predictable.
No.
Unless he was hitting that jukebox, because then you knew it was coming on.
Did you ever see the Fonz fight Tom Hanks? That was a weird episode.
What was Tom Hanks doing that he needed to be beat up? I forgot.
He came back like years later. Henry Winkler's character, the Fonz, picked on him or did something to him. And he became a karate expert and wanted to kill Hanks.
I don't picture Tom Hanks looking like a strong guy that could beat up Fonzie.
He had a karate
the likes
gi.
Of a Fonzie.
The karate gi made him look like badass, though.
Oh, he was wearing the gi?
Yeah. He like, you got to see this. If you haven't seen it.
Let me, I probably saw it, but I'm not remembering. But let me predict what the end was. They never fight. And everything ends up cool.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Of course.
But well, he kicked the Fonz through the window with a sidekick.
He did?
He gave him a shot. He just
did Fonz like, go, yeah. Whoa. Oh, there he is. Okay, we got any volume?
That's me.
Why is Fonz in a suit?
I know. Needles and pins.
Oh, he's trying to be the cool Fonz.
You know, you're like a little gnat. Now... I went to a Mozart concert, you know, and I'm having a nice quiet evening with some friends.
Fonz is trying to be
one
cool.
One of which you are not.
Keep it down. I hear you.
I can respect that.
Did you ever think watching this that
nice
he would
coat.
Become one of the greatest American
material.
Actors of our time?
Sure.
I mean Henry Winkler.
One thing wrong with it, though.
Oh, shit. He ripped the Fonz's sleeves off.
You might want to keep these in case you ever want to wipe what the your nose fuck? On your sleeve.
Isn't this show supposed to be like the 50s?
Oh, I can just knock it off.
Why is there a black guy in the bar? No, why was that one kid wearing a half shirt? This was after the show went to shit, by the way.
I know.
Oh, hey.
Whoa, I see you, gentlemen.
God, oh,
I do know a.
How do you think Henry Winkler is looking back at his career, realizing he was a water boy?
You should never want to go out with a real man.
Oh, thank you.
Here's my hotel room key.
He was still on the phone.
Use it.
Fonzie.
Uh-oh.
Now.
Thank you.
Whoa! Wait, they didn't fight. What happened? Oh, fuck this tie. I've got the leather jacket on. Is he beat up? Who was left on the show by this time? Wasn't it just Henry Winkler? Everyone else said, fuck it.
Ready to face oblivion. I'm ready for you and him.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
Wow. I had so many good times in that side of the table.
Hey, Mr. Miyagi's right there. What is that half shirt that faggot's wearing? All right, I've had enough.
Man, I'm peacing out, man.
I get the message.
Have a good one, Mike.
Thank you. What the fuck? He's still on the phone. So that was like bullying right there.
Yeah, but you know what, though? My favorite scenes in movies are when Miyagi opens a can of whip-ass and those idiots in the schoolyard. I loved it, man.
See, you like a lot of those scenes where the underdog kind of, you know, beats up the guy because probably you would beat on a little bit.
When I see Miyagi freak, I was like, the underrated old man, right? And he like just was like, boom, like lightning. And I was like, this is also my drinking days.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I was like, I got up on my table when I was really drunk watching The Karate Kid when they first had VCRs.
Yeah.
Especially the crane scene.
Oh, you would do the crane?
Yeah. I'm totally wasted off my ass. Right? Climb, call me there. Right?
And stand so, on like, one leg, because like, that's hard to do like this, when you're
like
drunk.
Wasted, right? My mom came in the room. She's like, what are you doing? I go like this. Daniel's going to kick his ass in.
Yeah, yeah. How old were you?
24 years.
24. I'm thinking 15. He's like 15. Hey, Mom. But you're 24 years old. Yeah. Doing the crane on a table drunk.